Stay tuned. Coming up next on Battle of the Planets, Tiny is suspended from the G-Force team and returns to his native fishing village, where he finds the townspeople terrorized by a giant sea creature.
Oh, Sean, this is going to be my mission. I don't need G-Force. They'll find out old Tiny can handle things by himself.
Be able to cope all alone with this latest terrifying invasion craft from the enemy planet Spectra? Can Mark and the rest of G-Force come to his aid in time to save him and thwart the plans of the evil Zoltar once again? Be sure to watch this exciting episode coming up next.
Center Neptune, where I keep watch on the entire universe for any sign of alien invaders, I've just checked out the entire Milky Way and given it an all clear. It's nice to be able to take a 10-second breather and know that all's right in the heavens. But I still have distractions right here on Earth. What is it, One Rover One? Oh, you can't be hungry already. Not 2 hours ago, I gave you a big bowl of kibbled carpet tacks. Well, here's something you can gnaw on until it's time for Din Din. I'm afraid I'll have to stop giving him those wrenches. He's not chewing on them. He's learned how to unscrew nuts and bolts. And yesterday, my whole ready room collapsed. Oh, there's an emergency alert. Center Neptune Control, 7 Zark 7.
Zark, I've just sighted a weird UFO out here. Is the Phoenix ready for blastoff?
It's standing by for launching, Commander. Just signal Tiny.
Phoenix, this is G-Force Commander. We have a bandit contact in your area. Repeat, bandit contact. Tiny, do you read me? Over.
G-Force, emergency. Come in, Tiny.
Tiny, respond. This is a red alert. Alien aircraft approaching.
I don't know what's wrong with Tiny and the Phoenix. Only thing I can do is warn the crews of all vessels in this area to abandon ship immediately.
Tiny, if you read me, keep your eyes open for an unidentified enemy rocket ship. I've alerted all vessels in this area, but they need help here.
You fell asleep? I didn't mean to, Chief. I just closed my eyes for a second, that's all. And the next thing I knew, Mark was calling me.
I've been trying to call you for 20 minutes. We thought something had happened to you for sure.
It scared us.
I didn't hear him. I wasn't wearing my wrist radio.
What?
You know that's against regulations.
Let me have it, Chief.
I'm sorry, but for the safety of the galaxy, I must suspend you from G-Force.
Yes, sir.
Wow.
Sorry.
Dumb, dumb, dumb. Jason was right. How could I be so stupid? What am I gonna do without a team? Might as well go back where I came from.
You gotta be kidding.
You're not gonna get me out there.
Papa, look who's here!
Tiny.
Hi, Cap. I'm back again.
Welcome home, Tiny. We're happy to see you.
Tell you the truth, nobody looks very happy, really. What's going on around here?
I'm afraid our town is in a lot of trouble. For a week now, the men have refused to take their fishing boats out.
Not taking their boats out? You're putting me on. This time of year, those fish are begging to be caught.
You don't know what's been going on, Tiny.
Boats disappearing, being wrecked.
Well, whatever it is, we're not going to let it spoil your vacation, my boy. I'm sure there's nothing you can do about it anyway. Now tell me, how long are you going to stay with us?
I'm not sure, Cap. Could be a long time.
We picked up fragments of the wreckage of several of the ships that were sunk, and also samples of the water in each area. Spectrographic analysis shows one common denominator in every case. A trace element that our scientists have been able to find on only one planet in the known universe so far.
My guess is spectra.
It's spectra, all right. But that still leaves us with two other problems. We've got to locate their base of operation, and then we've got to stop them.
I wish Tiny were here. I have a feeling we're going to need him.
That wasn't a manta ray, little buddy. And it's important you don't say anything to anybody about seeing it. Understand?
Okay, Tiny, if you say so, I won't tell anybody.
Captain!
Ah, Chief Anderson.
Good to see you again, sir. As I said on the phone, we're investigating the ships you reported sunk.
I've alerted everybody in town, Chief Anderson. Unless you can get to the bottom of this, we're finished.
We know some of the answers already. But before we get started, I'd like you to meet my colleagues.
Captain?
Tiny, look! It's them! It's G-Force! G-Force? Is it really you?
Tiny! Aren't you gonna say hello? How about it?
We got nothing to talk about, Mark.
Look, we're your friends, and we're gonna stay your friends no matter what you do or say. Tiny!
He's going without me! He promised I could help him catch the bat thing, and now he's going without me!
Bat thing? What kind of bat thing?
I can't tell you. Tiny said I shouldn't tell anybody, not anybody.
But I'm G-Force, just like Tiny. You want to help G-Force, don't you, Tommy?
Sure. I guess us G-Forces gotta stick together.
I'll show them. This is gonna be my mission. I don't need G-Force. They'll find out old Tiny can handle things by himself.
Thank you.
What could have happened to Tiny?
See how cleverly the fly manages to sneak into the spider's web. So sure he is unobserved. Soon I shall have two gifts for the Great Spirit. Let us hope his dreams are pleasant. Bring him in.
This is one of the worst things that's ever happened to G-Force. With Tiny suspended from the team and off on his own somewhere, Jason has to pilot the Phoenix. And that's really not his job. I'm certainly glad Chief Anderson is with the team on this mission. But even so, our entire operation is snafu without Tiny. I can't get through to any of them, and they can't get through to each other. But I've just got to keep trying. 7Zark7 to G-Force. Come in, Phoenix. Do you read me? Phoenix, come in.
Jason to G-Force Commander. Come in, Mark. Do you read me, Mark? I'm not getting anything. He must have shut off his homing beam.
Try other channels.
Nothing. I'm still coming up empty. I'm not getting a bounce from Tiny Sled either. I think right about now is a good time to start worrying.
A boat!
It's Tommy. It must be the Phoenix with G-Force.
Bring him aboard, Princess. I want to talk to him.
Come on, Tommy. There's really nothing to be afraid of. Believe me. Oh, wow! Neat! The Phoenix!
Tommy, we've been searching for Tiny and Mark. Where are they? Now, just take it easy, Tommy, and tell us what this is all about. Where did they go, and why is it your fault?
I promised Tiny I wouldn't tell anybody, and then Mark made me break my promise, and then I told him, and he said I could help him and work with G-Force, but now they're gone, and I'll never see him again.
On your feet, Earthling. Our commander wishes to speak with you.
I'll tell him anything. Then he'll turn me loose, won't he?
You will tell him everything and forget about your freedom.
He won't let me go? Oh, please, please. I'm afraid to stay here. I'm frightened.
If all Earthlings are this cowardly, our war will soon be over. Get up!
You guys are clumsy. Now, where will I find a head man around here?
Excellent, Gola. Excellent. You have captured the prize. The commander of G-Force himself. The great spirit will be pleased.
Thank you, Zoltar. That is all I ask. Shall I question him?
No, the questioning of the G-Force commander is a delight I have reserved for myself. And I hope he is not too eager to talk. It will be a pleasure to convince him.
The prisoner will be prepared for your interrogation.
The information he holds will make our invasion of Earth much easier. Look out! The cage!
Tiny, run! Get out while you can!
Pipe down, I'm busy.
Gora, do not let them get away. Destroy them if you have to, but they must not escape. I hold you responsible for the capture.
Attaboy, Mark. That ought to keep them out of here for a while.
Only trouble is, it's also going to keep us in here.
Well, you can't win them all, I guess.
In case I forgot to mention it, Tiny, thanks. I was beginning to feel like a prize turkey waiting for Thanksgiving.
You cannot escape, Earthlings. There is no place for you to go. You have trapped yourself.
Get lost. That's better.
Trouble is, he's right, Tiny. You know what the situation is, don't you?
I knew from the beginning. Do what you gotta do, Mark.
Phoenix, this is G-Force Commander. Do you read me? Over.
Mark, this is the Chief. Where have you been? We've been searching for you all day.
Sorry about that, Chief. But Tiny and I have been tied up. I'm afraid we're not going to be able to meet you.
What are you talking about? Just tell us where you are and we'll come down and pick you up.
Do you read me, Mark? Give us your location. We can't pick up your signal.
Mark, answer us. Where are you? We can't be very far away.
Skipper, don't be a hero. The good guys are sitting right upstairs. Give us a chance to join the party.
So these men couldn't escape.
We see your bubbles, Mark. The Phoenix is on its way.
Hang tough, Skipper.
We're coming, Mark. Tell Tiny we're going to get both of you out of there. Just don't give up on us.
Let's go. We can't make it. There's no way I can get the Phoenix through that opening.
The widget. Do you think we can jam three people into it?
Key up. You're the smallest. Go.
There.
Tiny, I'm sorry about everything that's happened. It was a bummer.
Forget it, Mark. Anderson was right. I'm just sorry you got yourself trapped in here with me.
Running out of time.
Not too late.
You.
I'm glad to have you back with us, Tiny.
That goes double for me, Chief.
If you're through making speeches, how about getting back here where you belong?
Quick, Tiny. He's a terrible pilot.
Phew. If that didn't rattle my primary electrostatic pentodes, nothing ever will. Fortunately, it all turned out well, and Tiny is back on the team and at the controls of the Phoenix. The Phoenix is on its way back to center Neptune, and G-Force is once again a united, well-coordinated team, ready to repel Spectra and cope with the worst that Zoltar can throw against us. Everything always turns out for the best. That's one of the wise old sayings that's been stored in my memory bank, and things certainly have turned out beautifully for me. I was just advised that I'm being sent up to planet Pluto next week to inspect our early warning system. Imagine, planet Pluto. That's where Susan is stationed. At last, I'm going to meet her. Center Neptune Control, 7 Zark 7.
Hello, Zark. This is Susan.
Susan, I was just thinking about you. I have wonderful news.
So have I. They're giving me all of next week off.
Oh, that's even better.
And I'm coming down to Earth for a vacation while some inspector is checking out my station up here.
I'm going to erase all of those wise old sayings stored in my memory bank.